Now I am starting with high calorific value. What is high calorific value? Suppose when a fuel is burned, then on burning the fuel, the heat is released, as we all know. But sometimes on burning the fuels, vapors are also there. Clear? So the vapors when we will condense those vapors, or when we will cool those vapors, then a latent heat of condensation is also liberated. So when the heat produced by a unit mass of the fuel plus when the product of combustion are cooled, clear? So two types of heat are added. One type of heat is when the fuel is burned, that heat plus the latent heat of combustion when the vapors condense or cooled at the room temperature. That is known as high calorific value. So high calorific value can be defined as total amount of heat produced when a unit mass of fuel is burned, clear, and the products of combustion are cooled at, I'm writing here it in short form, room temperature. Space is not there. Okay, I'm writing here room temperature. Okay, so high calorific value or gross calorific value is the sum of two types of heats. One, heat produced by the burning of the fuel, plus latent heat of condensation, which is produced when these products of combustion are cooled. And what is latent heat? Latent heat means the hidden heat. Clear? And we are using here latent heat of condensation. Condensation, you all know, cooling process. Okay, so next we have lower calorific value or net calorific value. So here, what is net calorific value? When it is only the net heat produced when a unit mass of fuel is burned. Okay, no latent heat of condensation is added to it. Okay, the fuels are not condensed. The vapors, they are let to be escaped from the apparatus in which the fuel is burnt. So net calorific value is only the net heat produced when a unit mass, or you can also write or unit volume here also, unit mass or unit volume of fuel is burnt completely and products of combustion are allowed to escape. And here in this high calorific value, the product of combustions, they are not allowed to escape, they are cooled and that heat is added to it. So here we can write one relation that net calorific value is equal to gross calorific value minus your latent heat of water vapors formed. Water vapors formed. So we can write it as this: net calorific value, that is gross calorific value minus the latent heat of water vapors formed. Next, we will do units of calorific value. Previous, we have done the units of heat. Units of calorific value for solid / liquid fuels, we use the unit calorie per gram or kilocalorie per kg. Okay, and second, for gaseous fuels we use kilocalorie per cubic meter. Okay, this is the unit of, or it can be also used as British thermal unit upon cubic feet, F3. This is cubic feet. Clear? In solid liquid we can also do this. This is calorie per gram, kilocalorie per kg, kilocalorie per cubic. It is read at as cubic meter, and this is read as cubic feet. So this is all about calorific value and types of calorific value. Now in next video we will do some numericals, or we will study about our liquid fuels.